Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 7th June, on the front page you have Rajnath inducted into cabinet panel following controversy. So this is Defense Minister Rajnath Singh. So he had been excluded from the subcommittees which have been, you know, cabinet committees which have been set up. So two cabinet subcommittees were set up for economic growth and investment and for jobs and skills. So these and the six other cabinet subcommittees have been established, but Defense Minister Rajnath Singh was excluded of them. So his name has now been added to the Political Affairs Cabinet Committee on Political Affairs, so as well as Committee on Jobs and Economic Growth. So despite being number two in the government as per the, you know, the protocol, still he was excluded. So now he's included. The next is RBI cuts interest rate by 25 basis points. So this is regarding the RBI Monetary Policy Committee. It has cut repo rate by 25 basis points to 5.75% to address the growth concern. So when repo rate gets cut, interests are expected to be going low for banks also, because for banks interest to be paid to RBI for short-term loans is low. So banks should also reduce their interest rates commensurately is what is expected. So that would make credit easily available in the economy, which will boost growth, so boost investment and growth. So here you can see the repo rate over the years is given. Then below you have Easter bombings, new evidence points to lapses. So this is regarding Sri Lankan bombing on Easter Day, April 21, 2019. So here now the news comes that there had been evidence, there had been intelligence, but they were ignored. So the former officials have given said that they had warnings. You can see here is the example of IGP. He told Parliamentary Select Committee set up to investigate on the April 21 attack that he received two calls on an imminent threat after receiving a similar letter on April 9 from the Chief of National Intelligence. He said, I got two calls from the Director of the State Intelligence Services, one on the evening of April 20 and one early in the morning on April 21. He said, tomorrow will be dangerous, something can happen, and on April 21 also something can happen today. So there was clear intelligence. Then below you have All India Radio may have to power off shortwave transmissions. So it says if Prasar Bharati has its ways, All India Radio will have to stop all global shortwave transmissions. So AIR began international broadcasting in 1939. All India Radio is actually resisting this move, arguing that shortwave transmissions is crucial for its global reach. It says shortwave is the only effective way to reach any part of the world. Then on page 4, you have part 3 of Yamuna River coverage. So it's been going on for the last 2 days. So this part talks of how increased water volume will reduce pollution in Yamuna. And it says that plans to augment river flow have missed deadlines. And below you have NGT forms panel to discuss plea seeking ban on plastic packaging. So NGT, National Green Tribunal, has formed this committee, an expert committee, to ascertain whether further norms are required to restrict the use of plastic packaging. So based on a petition, this committee has been formed. So it comprises representatives from Central Pollution Control Board, Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, Bureau of Indian Standards, and Directorate of Health Services. Then on page 5, you have CCI imposes penalty on pharma companies' trade associations. So Competition Commission of India has found certain pharmaceutical companies as such to be violating the provisions of Competition Act of 2002. The allegation is that they, you know, have been mandating this no objection certificate prior to appointment of stockists. So you know, the chemists as such. So this was stifling competition in the market by limiting access of consumers to various pharmaceutical products, and they were controlling supply of drugs in the market. On page 6, you have Tripura government's bid to boost school education. So Tripura government has decided to effect some major changes in primary and school education in the state. One such initiative is common uniform papers in all government schools. So this, there is also point praised on the failure of the no detention policy. So now students studying in class 5 and above would have to appear in examinations. And this is Odisha Deer Park faces closure. So this is 3-decade-old deer park at on Berhampur University campus in Ganjam district in Odisha. But it is said this will be shut and its animals shifted to Gajapati district. So there are around 55 spotted deers in the park, which have become too small for the increased number. The deer park is too small. It's on 2.2 acre land. So it was opened in 1989. Initially, it's only a pair of spotted deer. So numbers have increased over the years. Now they would be shifted and this park would be closed. Then on page 10, you have Center to come up with policy on artificial intelligence cybersecurity soon. So this is Niti Aayog, which will come up with a policy on the two aspects, artificial intelligence and cybersecurity, and it will be taken up by the Union Cabinet. It says there is a need to skill our people in machine learning. On the editorial page, the first editorial is No Surprises. So this says RBI has played conservative in announcing a rate cut of just 25 basis points. So a rate cut was expected, but just a 25 basis points is would not be sufficient, is what this editorial argues. And this is Sudan on the brink. So this is regarding how military rules and rulers in Sudan are using force against peaceful protesters. And the editorial says that the military rulers must climb down and transfer power to a civilian government, as demanded by the protesters. And this is Language, the opening move. So this is regarding the Hindi controversy which emerged recently. So it says this foretells the larger political narrative for the coming years. And this is Pakistan's blasphemy order. So this is regarding the language. The second language, this has been an issue. So you should know about the language issue as such, the entire history as such, especially in Tamil Nadu. It's a colonial legacy, question of language education. And this is Pakistan's blasphemy ordeal. So this is regarding the accusation of blasphemy on Asia Bibi. She has recently shifted now to Canada. So it says that just the accusation of blasphemy can be punishment for the accused and their defenders. Then on Fridays, you have this Parli coverage on op-ed page where there's a question and view counter view given. So is this the end of the road for Congress Party? So again, this is political news. So it's one aspect says it needs an organizational reboot and a firm ideology to differentiate itself from other parties. So viewpoints are given here. On international page, you have African Union suspends Sudan, seeks civilian rule. So more than 100 have died in the military crackdown on the protesters, and now Sudan has been suspended from the African Union, the Union of African Nations as such. And this is Taiwan's new move to buy US arms riles China. So Taiwan is proposing that it would be buying arms from USA. So this has angered China. Taiwan's defense minister wants 108 battle tanks and 250 anti-aircraft missiles, which is seeking to procure from USA. And here you have Russia willing to drop new START pact. So Russian President Vladimir Putin said that Russia is prepared to drop a nuclear weapons agreement treaty with the US and warned of global catastrophe if Washington keeps dismantling the global arms control regime. On business page, you have keeping close watch on NBFCs, says Shaktikant Das. The RBI Governor Shaktikant Das, he said that the RBI will ensure NBFC sector remains healthy. Also, draft norms for on-tap license for small finance banks has been released. Then below you have RBI waives NEFT RTGS fee to review ATM fees too. So now to boost digital fund transfers, RBI has decided to waive off charges for fund transfer via RTGS, that is real-time gross settlement system, and which is there for large value and instantaneous fund transfers, and even NEFT, National Electronic Fund Transfer, for other fund transfers. So both these the charges have been waived off, and also it is considering review of ATM fees. Then here you have lower leverage ratio may improve lending activity. So RBI's decision to bring leverage ratio for banks in line with Basel III standards, it says, will improve the lendable resources, bankers say. And on page 18, you have DHFL downgrade puts mutual fund assets at risk. So this downgrade by the credit rating agency of DHFL papers, as such, this could result in mutual funds being affected, which have cumulative exposure of 5,237 crore in DHFL papers. So this is a cause of concern. And on the last page, you have ecologists have 596 reasons to cheer. So this is regarding various plants and animal species which have been discovered in India in 2018. So Botanical Survey of India and Zoological Survey of India publications talk of that. So these are the important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for today. Thank you.